Hey guys, welcome back to another video. I'm Caitlin Bongers and I'm a Dutch illustrator. In this video today, I'm going to be working on two little postcard designs. I don't know yet if I actually want to make postcards of these designs, but the idea is that I do want to make postcards at some point, and I thought I'd just practice a little bit. And as some of you guys know, if you follow me, I work a lot in my sketchbooks and I usually like to do all my finished work also in my sketchbook. But today I'm actually working on some really fancy loose sheets of watercolor paper. This is the Kensen Heritage Hot Press. I think it's 300 GSM. It's really smooth. It's like my favorite paper to work in, and I definitely would want to work with this like every day of my life if it wasn't so damn expensive. It actually isn't too bad if you look at it and if I would use both sides. It's like an euro per A4 sheet, and these cards are A6 size, so I cut them down. So it's 25 cents per piece. But still, if you paint a lot and you use a lot of paper, it can still get really expensive. The reason I'm working on these little sheets instead of my usual working in my sketchbook is actually because I wanted to improve my composition a bit. And I find it a little bit easier if there's like a set frame for myself to see how the composition is going to look like on the final postcard, because it's of course in the size of the actual postcard. And normally I would like do a sketch first on a different piece of paper, and then I would take a picture of that, put it on my iPad, use my iPad as lightbox, and then trace it on the watercolor paper, and then I would start like my usual work that I'm doing right now on the screen, where I would line and actually color the design that I made. But here I just wanted to like work really loosely and just work directly on the paper. So all of the sketches are not something that I planned beforehand. I just made it up on top of my head. So yeah, I think they work out quite well, but definitely if I'd done some thumbnail sketches, they probably would have been better. I'm actually doing something a little bit differently than I normally do when I paint. Normally I just make my pencil lines very clear and then I just paint using my pencil lines as a guidance. And then if I want to add any line art, I'll usually do that in the end. And then I use darker colors of the versions that I used in the painting. And then I do it that way. Now I wanted to try to line my painting first with light watercolor. Like, I'm using a bluish watercolor here since I knew it was going to be like a ocean scenery. So yeah, I thought that like a bluish line art would fit. And then I just go on top of this line art with the rest of my watercolors. And then maybe like when I'm done in the end, you will see that I used blue ink to actually finish off the line work to make it look a little bit more crisp. Because of course, if you use watercolors and you're gonna layer a lot on top, then you might lift off some of the watercolor paper and your lines will get a little bit fuzzy. I really like this way of working. It made it a little bit easier, because usually when I just use my pencil lines as line art, it gets very hard to see somewhere in the middle of the painting. And now I could see my lines more clearly, and that was, it was nice to work with. And also, sometimes when I use my pencil work as my line art, you can actually still see the pencil lines when the piece is finished, and I don't like the look of gray pencil lines in my work. That's why you also can see me like sometimes use colored pencils to sketch out my piece with, or I'll very carefully trace and then I erase most of it. But here, of course, if I did my line work in pencil and then I went over with it in watercolor and then I erased the rest of my lines, it gets a lot cleaner, I think. So I was really happy with that effect, but I do dislike that I haven't really planned out my colors yet, so I don't really know if maybe I wanted to use like a different color line art because I wanted to do the hair red and now my lines are blue and I don't know if I want blue line work with red hair. So that's what I dislike about it. But if I plan out my colors a little bit more, of course I could just change that up and do the right color from the beginning. These pieces were also meant for me to just be a little bit experimental with my brushes. I haven't bought any new brushes in over a half year and I was starting to notice that a lot of my brushes kind of are not as sharp anymore. It kind of gets a little bit harder to paint with. So this was kind of a test to see which brushes I like and which brushes I probably should replace and get new ones of. In the beginning you saw me use different brushes for line art. I had this one brush that's like a part squirrel hair and then the tip is made of sable hair. And although that was a really nice brush when I bought it, but and it holds, like the squirrel hair is meant to hold a lot of paint while you can paint with the tip of the sable hair. But it kinda doesn't work for me that way because I feel like I don't have enough control to work in like these very small paintings that I made. And the reality is just I don't like painting big and I'll probably won't do as many big paintings in my life, and losing so much control for that, I just didn't really like it. So this is the piece that I actually made with that brush. And you can just see that on the fur of the animal that I drew and also on the like leaf thingies that are sticking out of its back, it's just not that controlled. And I mean, I still really like this piece and I think the line art looks fine, but I just wish there were like some parts where I had a little bit more control. The other brush that I used for the line art of the mermaid piece is just a regular sable hair brush. I think it was a size 2 or maybe a size 3. And I actually quite like that. So I do think that it doesn't hold a lot of paint. I have to re-dip it quite often. And I do think that these like cheaper sable brushes, they wear out quite quickly for me, so I actually decided to buy a little bit of a higher quality sable brush. You of course don't see me use it in this picture because I didn't have it yet, but yesterday I decided to buy a Winsor & Newton Series 7 size 2 sable brush, and I've used it twice now and I'm very happy with it. So yeah, I think that's gonna be my liner brush for the at least the next couple of paintings, and hopefully for a very long time. But I will make you forget all your sorrows. Let go like there's no tomorrow. Let's have a drink, just relax. All your problems will fade. If you're ready for a good time, count on me. There's a party in the backyard, dance your problems away. I'm all about the good vibes. I know you're all about the good vibes.
Do you know how much I love you? Wanna see you
smile. The brush I used the very most in this painting was definitely this brush that I'm holding right now. It's the silver brush, black velvet. I think it's a size 3, and it's definitely one of my favorite brushes that I use a lot. I actually have it for quite some time now. I think I have it for like 5 or 6 months, and I have used it a lot. I think it stays quite nice for how much I've used it. I also have a bigger version of this brush that I also use quite a lot, but I don't think I've used it in this painting. And yeah, I was just generally really happy with this brush, so I don't really need to replace it. I did think that it was a little bit too small for this painting that I was working on, and I would really have preferred like a one size bigger brush. I do have some old sable brushes that I try to use, but they're so old and so frayed I don't have a lot of control over them anymore. So I did also buy one new brush that's a little bit bigger than this one, just a new sable brush also, to bring one fresh new brush into my collection. I do think that brushes are like a little bit strange. It always feels not good for me to buy new brushes. I don't know if you can like understand what I mean, but I don't know what's the point when a brush needs to be replaced. I find that if I paint with a brush for a very long time and then at a certain point it just doesn't feel really smooth anymore, and I get a hard time controlling my edges, and I just can see myself making mistakes, but otherwise the brush is still perfectly fine to use. Like, I can still fill in the big pieces that I want to paint in. So it feels weird to replace a brush. I also take very good care of my brushes, so actually the signs of my brush wearing down are very, very small. But I wanted to ask you guys, what is for you guys a clear sign that you need to get some new brushes? Or do you guys ever throw away old brushes? What do you do with old brushes? I just don't know. It feels like it just feels like a waste. And I have some of my old brushes that weren't really usable anymore that I now use for actually glazing my ceramic pieces, but I now have like 5 brushes to glaze my ceramic pieces, and I don't really need more than those. So, I have talked a little bit about the paper that I'm using. I've talked a lot about the brushes that I'm using. I just want to say that these watercolors that I'm using are the Agallo watercolors. I will leave a link to them in the description. I have them since a couple of weeks and I've fallen absolutely in love with them. I just really enjoy painting with these watercolors. I do also need to give my other watercolors some love, and I will definitely paint with others soon. But for now, they're just really great. Of course, the ceramic palette that you see on the screen is my own, and I still have some available on my Etsy store, and I will also leave a link in the description if you want to check them out. I'm now doing some final touch-ups to both the pieces with this Liquitec acrylic ink. And I don't use this ink quite often, but I really love the effects that it gives here, so I think I'll definitely use it more in the future. I have a couple of bottles of this ink. I have a red, a blue, and like a brown, I think. And it just looks really crisp and something different than always using black lines. Yeah, my hopeless soul. And with that, we're at the end of the video. I hope you liked it. If I would do this again, I would definitely change the hair color of the mermaid. But oh well, I learned from it and it's okay. If you like any of these two pieces and would like to see them as a postcard, definitely let me know. I haven't made any choices yet of which designs I'm going to make into postcards. And if you liked the video in general, just give it a like, leave a comment, subscribe to my channel, that would be nice. And yeah, I make videos every Wednesday, so I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!